Hello, everyone. It has been a little while, but y'all know what we're about to do, okay? First of all, I want to apologize because it has been like about a month, I think, ish, since I posted the last One Direction reaction for Take Me Home. I read through y'all's comments. Y'all's is waiting for this one. There were like 4 comments. It wasn't a big deal. Also, I do want to say I was aware that after this point, like the boys are writing the songs, some of them, if not like most of them or whatever. And I was aware that Louis is a big part of the songwriting. I did not know that Liam wrote a lot of the songs, but there you go. Also, let me show y'all something because I am a fanatic. Your boy bought this shit on CD. Okay, so right now the CD isn't in here because it's in my car. But I got a deluxe edition, and so did my friend Emily. We got the deluxe edition of Take Me Home, which we thought was going to have all the tracks, but apparently the yearbook edition and the deluxe edition, there's like 3 editions of this album, but I have the bonus tracks, Truly, Madly, Deeply, Magic, Irresistible, One Thing Live, and I Wish Live. So we got some Up All Night tracks on here too. And yeah, anyway, I just wanted to show y'all that I thoroughly enjoyed Take Me Home. I'm very excited for this one, Midnight Memories. And of course we're excited for 4. And we're excited for Made in the AM too, even though I know that we're not gonna talk about Made in the AM yet. We'll get to that. Anyway, I know a few songs from this one. I know Midnight Memories. I just tested the audio on my computer and saw that Best Song Ever is the first one on here. So let's get into it. My hair also, I'm sorry. I don't know what's going on with the hair today. Just deal with it. All right, first track. We know and love Best Song Ever. It was a single, if I'm not mistaken. Let's get into it.
Maybe it's the way she walks. So we danced all night to the best song ever. We know it every night. And oh, oh. Yeah. Oh, oh, oh. Period.
So obviously I'm putting a heart to this one already because we just know we love this one.
And we danced all night to the best song ever. We know it every night to the best song ever. Like, oh, oh, oh. Yeah. Like, oh, oh, oh.
Oh my God. I did not know that's how that part goes. But those drums are intense. You know I know who that was.
To the best song ever.
Period. Harry? I think that was Harry. Unless that was Zane. I don't know. I never know.
Yeah.
Who the fuck did that? That's gotta be Zane. What are y'all expecting me to say? We're not even going to talk about it because y'all already know everything's perfect. Story of My Life, track 2. Here we go. Also know this one, obviously. Oh, shit.
Written in these walls are the stories that I can't explain.
I haven't heard this song in a really long time. I need to listen to the lyrics.
The story of my life, I take her home. I drive all night to keep her warm inside. It's frozen.
Oh, time is frozen. Background vocals on point. There's Louis. How are you gonna give the second verse to Louis and Niall? You're breaking the heart. The story of my life. I take her home. I drive all night to keep her warm in time. It's frozen. Story of the story. I like those little story of the story of my life. Okay, story of my life. I mean, we already knew, we loved. I missed like the whole first verse. I kind of like, in terms of lyrics, I wasn't really paying attention. I'm sorry. The second verse, I guess, too, kind of, I was like in and out of consciousness because I was just listening to their beautiful voices. But I'll get the lyrics once I listen more. You know what I'm saying? But obviously, we love Story of My Life. I knew that one because it was a single back in the day. I remember that shit on the radio all the time. Now on to track 3, Diana. I'm pretty sure I've heard parts of this one because my girl Emily, but let's listen all the way through for the first time. That shit hit hard. Diana. How could someone not miss you at all? Ooh. Diana. Let me be the one to light a fire inside those eyes. You get lonely, you don't even know me. Baby, you'd be saving my life. Damn. Diana, I wanna reach out for ya. They keep giving Louis and Niall the same section, and I'm loving it. Oh, save your life. I thought he was saying take your life the first time around, and I was like, what? But now I get it. Period. Yes! Diana. Diana is getting a fucking heart, of course. Holy shit, dude, the drums, like those, like, because obviously, okay, I forgot, I mean, I already knew this, but like, I forgot to say it at the beginning, like, I'm aware that the album is very rock oriented, or like rock pop, because obviously it's still pop. They're killing it with those like first initial hits, like those power chords or whatever, where it's like dum, dum, dum. Like that shit is hitting hard with like the snare drums they're using, the chords they're using, the bass they're using, the guitars they're using, everything. Killing the game on production with this one. A little bit of a different style than Take Me Home, but still very One Direction, still very powerful, still very pop, all good things. The next track is Midnight Memories. Of course we know this one. Of course we love it. let's get right into it. Also, I do want to say, I forgot to say this, before we go on to Midnight Memories, the song, the lyrics in Diana, also very good. I don't know if they wrote this one. I don't have it up on my screen right now. Maybe I'll look at it later, but like, good lyrics. The one about like saving each other's lives or whatever, like, that's cute, that's powerful. The way he's saying it, the way they sang it was powerful. Anyway, Midnight Memories, here we go. Oh my god. I forgot how this starts. You could have made an explicit version, boys. Midnight Memories. Oh, oh, oh. This goes so much harder than I remember.
A different day. Tell me that I'm wrong, but I do what I please. Midnight memories. Oh, oh, oh. Singing, 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 singing. Midnight memories. You and me and all our friends. I don't care how much.
Speeding it up here. Which boy was that? Oh shit, that one ends so quick. Oh god, y'all, I just saw what's up next. For the longest time, I thought that You and I was on 4. Okay, I have heard this song. I'm going to preemptively heart it. First of all, let me give Midnight Memories some attention. I did not know that song went that hard. Like, obviously I knew Midnight Memories went hard, but like, I didn't realize it went that hard. I've never listened to it with headphones. I don't know if I've ever even listened to it in full, but like, I'm telling you, they're killing it with like the impact hits. Like the transitioning from like quiet, 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 and then like bursting into the chorus. They're killing that this time around. I mean, they're doing it in the verses too in some scenarios. Like, they're surprising me with the power in the vocals, instrumental, drums, everything. Now, let's go and get fucked up for weeks. I don't know if I've actually ever even heard You and I in full, but I know about the Zayn high note. Let's get into it. Y'all are bullies. Y'all are trying to make me cry on camera.
Nothing can come between you and I. Not even the gods above.
Gods above.
Separate the two of us.
Two of
Nothing
us.
Nothing can come between you and I.
God damn that guitar.
I figured it out. See what it's like.
Louis.
See what it's like for day and night. Never together.
Bro, I love Louis' voice so much.
You see things in a different light. Like us, we never tried.
I forgot it goes.
Like us.
I forgot it goes down first time.
You and I. Separate the two of us.
Ooh, echo.
You and I, and
period, Zane. Bro, I did not know that's where that part came in. Like, I was expecting lyrics in the bridge. But that shit just went. I need to go back and listen again. I just caught that little da-da-da synth in the background. Bro. I mean, I already knew this was it, but this is it. You know? I mean, everybody been new. All right. Next track. Track 6. Don't forget where you belong. Let's get right into it. Okay, some intense piano. The rasp. Okay, a little cheesy with the ending there. The drums. The guitar strums. Ooh. That's what I was waiting for. You did not give the Louis a punch! When I think of the things I've done, don't matter where I'm gone. Is this Louis and Zane? Yo, this sounds like a basketball stadium or some shit, like basketball court with the reverb. Okay, that outro, we need to talk about that outro for a second while it's fresh in my brain. That like little reverbed synth sounded like a little saw synth. That shit was fire, that goddamn! The first chorus, I was feeling it, but I was like, I wish it was bigger, you know? And then the second chorus came in, and it hit the mark. Like, I was nervous at first because I thought, like, this is One Direction here. We're getting kind of like a, like, it still hit, but it wasn't like, you know? But then they built it up throughout the song, and that was dope. Because, like, in Take Me Home, when we got launched into the first chorus, it was big the whole time. You know what I mean? Like, that's what Take Me Home was to me, and that's why I like Take Me Home. But here we're getting some nice, at least in this song, I don't know how much this applies to the songs before this one, but in this one, we got like sort of a soft chorus the first time. Not soft. I don't know how to explain it. It wasn't like as layered as the ones that came after it though, you know what I mean? And that shit made it all the more satisfying because like you were wanting more and wanting more, and then it came to the final chorus and it was so big, and then the outro was also really nice and different. That was so good. I would have hearted it beforehand, but I was too busy in the moment to heart it before it ended. So don't forget where you belong. Got a heart. Also, the lyrics, sweet. I need to pay more attention. I didn't pay that much attention in the verses, but the chorus, super cute. Anyway, track 7 is strong. Let's get right into it. Okay, may have heard this one before.
My hands, your hands, no, in so many words. Ooh. We're not saying.
Don't that like little in the background.
You make me strong.
Oh.
I'm sorry if I say I need you. But I don't care who I'm weaker. Is that so wrong? Is it so wrong?
Ooh.
You make me strong.
Transitioning! Nice. So good. This is getting a heart already. The bass. I love that love. Is that so wrong? You make me. The vocals on this album.
You make me strong.
Nice.
Sorry if I say I need you.
Is this Niall?
I don't care. I'm not scared of love.
Damn, Niall! This isn't Niall, I'm gonna be so embarrassed.
I'm sorry if I say I need ya, but I don't.
Nice!
With you, I'm weaker.
Is that so wrong? Is that so wrong?
That you make me strong?
Yo, you know what I just realized? Speaking of strong, that like echoey guitar sound that they used in the beginning and the end, and like I'm sure throughout, but like you hear it the most then. It gives me Stronger by Kelly Clarkson vibes. Also, off of, I don't know if it was Up All Night or Take Me Home, but there was a song that was apparently written by Kelly Clarkson that I said sounded like a Kelly Clarkson song, so. Your boy's got that good ear. Anyway, strong, great. Lyrically, melodically, vocally, everything. I literally, why do you guys watch these videos? I'm saying the same shit over and over again. Anyway, track 8, happily. I will happily listen to the rest of this fucking album. Here we go.
You don't understand, you don't understand.
I'm giving this a heart already. Do you hear these claps? Nice, nice. Cute. Oh. Maybe not cute. Nice strip down. Nice. Dude, the drums sound so good. Y'all, the vocals. I know y'all were saying, like, these boys hit puberty around Midnight Memories. We got Frat Boy Harry about Midnight Memories. They sound so good. Like, I mean, obviously they always did, but now we're getting more rasp. We're getting those controlled ass high notes. We're getting there. I have nothing bad to say. All right. Track 9, right now. Let's listen to this shit right now. Lights go down and Louis. Night is calling to me, yeah. Mm. Damn, that note on here, how he drops down. Whoa. Whoa. Nice layers, bro. You know, some of these songs that I'm putting a heart to right now, and this is why. Some of these songs, they're starting out, like, at first I'm thinking, like, ooh, I'm not sure if this is gonna be heartworthy. But then as it builds up, it's like a slow burn. Like, as the shit builds, I'm starting to get into it more and, like, feel it. Like, it just takes a minute to get into it, and then by the end I'm like, yes, you know what I mean? That's how these songs are going right now. I mean, like, some of them, I'm like, Midnight Memories, I was hooked right away. You know, like, there's some of them that I'm like, shit. And like, some of them that I know, obviously I knew some of these, but like this one, and I think, I can't remember what the other one was. Maybe it was Don't Forget Where You Belong. I don't remember which one I said the same thing about, but like, this was one where like the beginning, I was kind of unsure if it was gonna get a heart, but then by the end I was like, this is it. Anyway, next track is Little Black Dress. Let's get into it. Track 10. Here we go. I thought this was going to be a slow one. This is getting hard. Damn. What the fuck? This is giving me like a sense of nostalgia. Like, this actually sounds like something that could have come out of like old rock hits or something. Did I heart this already? I did. I wish I could heart this shit twice. I wanna see the way you move for me, move for me. Woo! The transitioning, and once again. Nice fade out. Nice. Yo, this one. So, a couple of things. So, I said, like, it reminds me of, like, old rock music. The way that they had, like, staccato, like, notes. For non-music people, this might be hard to understand what I'm saying, but I'll try my best to explain it. So, they had, like, staccato notes, basically, like, short notes, like, da 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 da. That melody and that rhythm and, like, the instrumentation at that part, and chords or whatever, everything, like the whole thing. Maybe not like the mixing. The mixing is modern. And some of the other sounds and like the chorus and stuff were modern. The songwriting and the chorus was modern. But like the other stuff in the verses sounded legit, like it was at, like part of me was questioning, like, is this sampled, like the melodies or the lyrics or something? Because that sounded legit like rock music, some of those elements. Also, another thing, the chords were getting me because I love a nice 4-1, which is basically like, I don't know how to explain this in non-music terms, but that kind of chord progression always gets me. Like there's 4-1s, or I don't know if it's 4-1s or 1-4, and like for instance Billie Eilish, I Love You, that shit hits hard, and that song has a 4-1 chord progression. Who the fuck cares, Joe, shut the fuck up. Anyway, track 11, Through the Dark. Let's get to, oh, if I didn't say it already, I think so far Little Black Dress is my favorite. I don't know. Anyway, Through the Dark, let's get into it.
See you smile again.
See you smile again.
But don't burn
that bass.
Even if you skip it.
Aww. The background vocals on this one. They're doing that a lot this time around. That was dope. Do it again. Period. Nice. Was that the end? No, it wasn't. Nice. All right, I already hearted that shit. Again, I don't remember when I started getting into it, but like in the beginning, I wasn't sure if I was gonna like it, but by the end, I was jamming. These songs are growers, man. As they build up, they double, like this shit has so much replay value, this album. I mean, so do the others. Through the Dark. I have nothing bad to say, y'all. Literally, I feel like people are gonna think I'm lying when I'm like, I'm like genuinely hype over this shit. I can't even remember what I wanted. There were like certain things I wanted to say that I really liked about it, but like just everything. Okay, I have nothing else to say. By the way, in case y'all need a little heart check, every single song so far has gotten a heart. So, okay, track 12. Something Great. I'm sorry for the puns, y'all, but I'm sure this song is gonna be something great. Okay, the vocals are a little quiet. Damn. I gotta pay attention to the lyrics. This guitar. The orchestra in this one is getting me. Ooh, that little Disney sound effect. Louis, that outro is the reason why this song is getting a heart. Bro, that shit caught me off guard. Dude, Louis's voice is so precious. How do I explain Louis's voice in words? It's soft, like, because he can belt, but even when he, like, belts, it's, like, cute. You know what I mean? I don't know how to say it. Anyway, let me talk about something great. So it almost didn't get a heart until that fucking outro, bitch. And this is why I wasn't going to give it a heart. So the transitioning wasn't there for me. Like, when it was bursting into the chorus, like, yes, I like that sort of thing. But I feel like it could have been done better. Because, like, a lot of times what you'll do when you're transitioning into a chorus or something with a big bang like that, you'll, like, reverse some sound effects and have it fade in quietly before bursting in, so you have kind of like, it gives your ear a warning that like something loud's coming and it sounds smoother. This kind of felt like, I don't know how to explain it, but it just didn't feel as polished to me with the transitioning. But overall, still a great song, songwriting wise instrumental wise it was great. I think I just need more time with it to get used to it, because it is different than some of these other songs. Like I was saying in like Take Me Home, I think it was in Take Me Home, right, Over Again, it sounds different than the other songs, but that doesn't mean it's bad. It just means I need to give it a few more listens to get into it. Like with Over Again now, love it. I've heard it, like, obviously a bunch more times because I have the CD and everything now. So, like, I think I just need more time with something great and I'll like the whole thing. I love that outro, though. I thought that the song was ending and then my boy Louis came in and surprised me. And y'all know how much I love my little guy, Louis Tomlinson. Anyway, track 13, Little White Lies. Let's get into it. I think maybe I've heard part of this one, but I'm not sure. I recognize the name anyway. Say it's getting late, it's getting late. Okay. Don't know if you can stay. Your hair's touching me. The guitar. And my boy Louis. When it's only me and you. Getting hard already. God damn. This sounds so good. Build it up. Nice. Period. Oh my god. I went to heart it and I already hearted it. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my. What the fuck? I don't know why that one got me so good. Bro, I think, okay, you know what part of it was? Is that like, okay, how do I start? There's so many things. So, first of all, the guitars, great. Like, in the verses, there's like these da-na-na-na or whatever. I don't know exactly what notes they were, but there were like three or four notes that were like stacked one after another, like played one after another with like a reverb effect. Sounded so dope. And then the chorus, how... The way that, like, this is through all the albums, I guess. The way that they mix acoustic instruments in with, like, electronic instruments, it's been done so well in all three of these albums so far. Another thing I wanted to say is that in the chorus, I don't know if it was throughout the whole thing or just in the chorus, but I noticed it most in the chorus, they had this bass that, like, kind of sounded like a guitar that gave me, like, Teenage Dream vibes by Katy Perry. Teenage Dream by Katy Perry, in the chorus, they have... and they have like the note like drop out like that, and it sounds like a guitar-ish kind of sound like that, but it's like still synthesized and like I couldn't really tell if in this song if it was a guitar sound that they just manipulated to drop off at the end, or if it was just a synth, like how in Teenage Dream it's a synth or whatever. But I love that kind of sound, especially since it just reminded me of that other song that I love so much. So like, overall, just a great track. Now let's get into Better Than Words, track 14. Oh, also about Thin White Lies, not Thin White Lies, God, that's what I was gonna say. I think the reason why I've never heard it before, I think the reason why I thought maybe I've heard it is because of the song Thin White Lies by 5/6 of Summer. I thought I realized that when I was reading the title too, but I thought maybe I know Little White Lies as well, but it turns out I don't. Anyway, track 14, Better Than Words, let's get right into this shit. Wow. Times, bitch. God damn, that's so cool. Sum it up, sum it up, sum it up, sum it up. Dude, their vocals. Fade out again. There's a lot of fade outs on this album. It works though. It works. Let me tell you. Better Than Words. Apparently, I already hearted it. I literally... Dude, I am taken to a different universe with some of these fucking songs. I don't even remember hearting it halfway through, but apparently I did. So good. I don't know what else to say. Let's just go right into track 15. Why don't we go there? Here we go. Okay, okay, okay. God damn, this one's so hype already. That one, I don't know when the fuck I hearted it, but I remember hearting it midway through. That shit was so hype. Also, I wanted to say this about Better Than Words. Wasn't there a different song that they have that's called like More Than Words or something? Wait, I'm gonna look through their track list right now. More Than This, maybe that's what I was thinking of. Anyway, I just wanted to say that. But Why Don't We Go There, really good. There was also, I don't remember what song it was, there was a different one that had sort of a melody that sounded like Hallelujah. I'll put like a little like thing that says what song I'm talking about. But yeah, okay, like, you know the song that's like from like Shrek or whatever? Hallelujah. That shit. There was like a melody from one of these songs that gave me that, and I'll put whatever song I'm talking about right here because I don't remember off the top of my head. But anyway, talking about Why Don't We Go There. Lyrics on this album are a little frisky, gotta be said, but of course we don't mind. And that was just an overall great track. I literally have nothing new to say. Like, these tracks are just so... That's one thing. Like, the transitions in this track, really polished. Track 16, Does He Know? Let's get into it. The songs that you sing when you're all alone. I forgot it was a key change. Like, what? That works so well. I'm already giving it a heart. Build it back up. Yes! Oh, 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 oh. Oh, 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 oh. What the fuck? Okay, that's... Emily Wilson? Once again, we have a joint playlist. And this song isn't on it? I'm angry at you. And we may never speak again. I cannot believe that you have held this song hostage from me for 7.5 years. Okay. Track 17. Alive. Let's get into it. Emily Wilson? We're over. This is some bullshit. It's getting a heart. Nice. Yo. It's all right. Life. Dude, I haven't been paying attention to the lyrics. And live while we're young. They're just gonna act like that was nothing? Was awful. Period. Okay, I'm really sad because that's the second to last song. We only have one more song off of this album, but these past two have been like, the whole thing has been amazing, but for some reason these last two have hyped me up so hard. And we have an ad break right now, so Emily Wilson, this is rude. I cannot believe that you've really sat here and just waited for me to discover this album. Why have you kept this from me? Why have you not handed me this? Why have you not let me experience this masterpiece? That's all I'm asking. Anyway, the last track is Half a Heart. This is gonna, if this fucks me up as hard as Irresistible did, I'm gonna be pissed. Is this
so your friends been telling me you've been sleeping with?
This is already giving me, with the instrumental, Truly Madly Deeply vibes. Just wanted to say that off the bat.
Because I'm missing half of me.
Ooh.
And being here without you, I'm walking around with just one shoe. I'm half a heart without you. I'm half a man at best. Forget all we said that night. No, it doesn't even matter.
The drums are really nice.
Being here without you is like I'm waking up to only half a blue sky. I'm half a heart without you. Half a heart without you.
The way they've incorporated like violin and stuff into the song.
Though I try to get you out of my head, the truth is, and since then I've been waking up to without you, without you, half a heart without
vocals.
You, without you, without you, half a heart without you.
Nice. Of course it's getting a heart. What a nice out, like sad, but nice outro. So from what I can tell lyrically, like they're both missing each other. So like, I don't know why they ain't together no more if they're both sad about the breakup. But anyway, great song, great album. Every single song hearted. Every single song. Once again, I literally, y'all, I'm so sorry that I'm so late to the party, but just blame Emily. Just blame Emily. I also wanted to show you guys, speaking of Emily, I'll be right back. Miss Amelia Bedelia got me a gift. We had a very late postponed Christmas Secret Santa gift exchange, and she got me two vinyls, one of which, y'all already know! So, I don't know if y'all have seen this, but it's fucking gorgeous. Like, the actual disc. I just want to show it off because I think it's epic. And it kind of matches my outfit right now, so basically, it's transparent vinyl, but with black and white splatter paint all over it, and it looks so incredible. It sounds so incredible. Of course, the album is incredible. Fine Line by Harry Styles, in case y'all are fake fans and didn't know what album it is. I just want to show that off because One Direction, you know. Okay, so that's my reaction to Midnight Memories. Love it upon first listen. So the thing is that I'm trying to debate now. Like, I've only heard it once, so I don't know if it'll grow on me, but as of now, I think I like Take Me Home better. Don't quote me on that though. Again, this is my first listen. My favorite song on here, I remember really liking Little Black Dress, but there was another one that I liked. I think it might have been Little White Lies. I don't know. I'll put a little shit right here saying which one I'm thinking of. In case anybody's wondering, I am going to be reacting to 4 and Made in the AM. I don't know when I'm gonna post those videos because like this one was like a month later or whatever, and that's because I was doing a Taylor Swift reaction, which go check that out, I guess, if you like Taylor Swift. I want to hear my thoughts on Folklore and Evermore. That is up on my channel right now. So even if I post other reactions in between my One Direction reactions, I'm still doing it. So don't worry if you're here for the long run and you want to watch me react to the rest of the albums, I will be doing it. It just might take a little bit of time. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this reaction. I definitely did. By the way, I'm looking at the cover now. Niall looks fine as hell on the cover. Dude, what? Even though I wasn't like necessarily a fan of One Direction back in the day, I remember Niall was always my favorite boy for the visuals, you know what I'm saying? I also know that this was apparently like frat boy Harry era, and I'm sure he was very attractive as well. I mean, they're all very attractive boys, let's be real here. Anyway, thank you guys for watching. I'm sorry for the super long outro. Stay tuned for 4 is up next. I can't fucking believe it. This album was incredible. 4 is supposed to be better, apparently, according to Emily at least, and like some other One Direction fans. 4 is like the best album, so I'm very hyped. I'm kind of scared because I'm like, I'm gonna be, because like it's so exciting leading up to it, but then I'm gonna listen to it and there's gonna be nothing to look forward to, but like I also have Made in the AM to look forward to. Anyway, Midnight Memories, great album. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in the next part. Peace. One last thing I want to say, because I forgot I wanted to say this, which is like not related to the video at all, so like I'm sorry, but like it's beautiful. So I just want to remember this, because half of the reason why I record these videos is for myself. If I ever want to look back at my original reaction to things, I just want everyone to know that it's, oh, you can't see. There we go. It's snowing outside and it's beautiful. Anyway, goodbye for real now.